Welcome to Finding Holiness, where we delve into timeless Torah wisdom, revealing the sacred in everyday moments. Join us on a journey to elevate your spirituality and discover holiness in every aspect of life. I'm your host, Rabbi David Kadosh, and together, let's embark on a path of spiritual exploration. I hope you enjoy this next episode. All right, continuing with the laws of Akhsharat Kelim. Isn't it? Pnine Halakha here has an interesting discussion with regards to metal utensils nowadays. He says, She'ela hit'orera bi'amenu legabe klei matechot. A question arises in our days with regards to metal objects, metal utensils. Barur shechachmei ha-mishnah ve'ha-talmud ha-rishonim ve'ha-charonim mityachasu leklei matechet kebolim u'portim ta'amim. No question that in the days of the Talmud, metal objects had the ability to absorb and the ability to emit. Ve'en safek shekach hashu befoal. There is no doubt that it was true. V'lachen nifsak, and that's why it was made a halakha, shimevashlim basir matechet basar taref. If you cook treif in a metal pot, hasir bolea tame taref, the pot absorbs taref. V'im lifne shiuchshar ba'agala yibashlu bo tafshil kasher, and before you kosher it, you cook some kosher meat, lamnot sheniku et asir etev, even if you would have cleaned the pot properly, la'itim yachushu betafshil tam shebasar taref. We're worried that maybe that it would acquire some taste of the forbidden foods. Lefichach, im haya sham goy amin, if there was a responsible, trustworthy goy, sheta'amet atafshil, and tasted the dish, umatza she'en bo tam taref, and he saw that there was no taste of treif, hechshilu tatafshil, they kosher it. Aval im lo haya sham goy amin, but if there was no trustworthy goy, kavu, she'esh lachmir ulachshiv et hadefanot, we were machmir to calculate the walls, ki'ilu hen meleot betam, shekulo nifal tafshil, that they were filled with forbidden taste, that now was emitted and injected into the dish. Ve'kevan she'en betafshil, pishishim keneged ove hadefanot, since there's not 60 times the volume of the walls of the pot, osrim et hatafshil. This is what we spoke about already. Uvadai shechumra zo itpasesa lametziyut shekilo haramim, there's no question that this chumra was based on the actuality that they've discovered back then. Shegam le'achal shemenakim etzira matechet etev, and even if you clean the pot well, la'itim nitan le'argish betafshil etam hatafshil shebishlu bo lifneken. You're going to taste something. Mineged, however, conversely, yadu ala nashim bi'amenu, it is known amongst people today, she'la'achal shemenakim etasirim karaui, that after you clean the pot nowadays, lo nishar ba'em shemetz mitamo shetafshil hakodim. You have no taste of what you just cooked prior. Ve'en adam she'asliach lachush etam hatafshil shebishlu bo lifneken. And as much as you're going to try, you're not going to taste the lasagna that you made yesterday in your London broil that you're going to make today. You're not tasting it. Gam kach gam hitparel memechkarim shonim. It has also been clarified through lots of investigation. Shebliat kli matechet uzchuchit ma'ata kol kach ad she'en efsharut lachush mimena shum tam. That what is absorbed in metal and glass utensils today is so small, so minute, that there's no way in the world that that's going to be affecting your food. Hashela ma'ishana bedorot aharonim. What happened in the last few generations where this changed? Kefi anira hasiba leshinui ne'utza b'mispar pituchim technologim. That it seems that the answer is based on technology. Rashid, ba'ava lo nitan haya latzek et ha-matechet be'ofan achid. In the past, we weren't able to pour the metals through this vacuum tube. I guess that's how they made metals. In which, through the nozzles, we're able to help create thicker walls. It could be that the metals were less pure. And the alloys were able to absorb taste. Shenit, more than that, ba'avar penei hakelim hayu yoter mechuspasim, the actual walls of the kli were rougher, u'memela haya kasheh yoter le'asir mehem et shariyut ha'tafshil, it was very difficult to remove anything that was left over from the walls. Shelishit, third, chelek mashmauti me'atam shenotar ba'kelim la'achar ha'bishul nava me'ashuman shenitbak aleihem, that there was actual part of the taste that was stuck as a result of the grease that that was stuck onto the walls. וגם תמימנו נחשבו כבלויים בכלי. And even though we still have this issue, הויל ונעשו לחדים הדפנות פלים להם, בעקבות פיתוח סבון הכלים לפני פחות מאה שנה, now that we have developed special dish soap, okay, within the last 100 years, וחיבור הבתים למים זורמים, as well with running water, ניתן בעזרת מים וסבון עם מטלית קרצוף, with a scrubber, להשיא את השומנים והלכלוכים הדבוקים לכלי. Yeah, all right, so now we have 4 times as strong dish soap, okay? We have a scrubber, you have a running water, continuous hot water, okay? And there is going to be nothing left of your previous dish. Okay? So now that's the reality. So now does that change the halakha knowing that there is nothing that is going to affect the dish? So if I cooked meat in a pot just not long ago, can I use that pot, a metal pot for dairy, when I know it's not going to affect the holy sewer, that we're saying is going to affect my milk pot? But now I'm saying there's no way it's going to affect my milk pot because nothing absorbed. And even if there's absorbed, there's no way you're going to feel or taste anything. So yes, Toanim, there are those that claim that since nowadays the metal, right, like for the reasons we said, don't absorb and emit taste. לדעת המתירים להשתמש בכלי זכוכית לבשרי ולחלבי רותחים הידי ניקוי בלבד. Therefore, there are those, and since there are those, like we mentioned yesterday, there are those that allow meat and milk for glass, right? We gave the Mekil opinion, allow meat and milk for glass. צריך גם להתיר להשתמש בסירים מופסקים ממתכת לבשרי ולחלבי רותחים הידי ניקוי בלבד. Same for metal. There are those that hold, you have your forks, you have your knives, okay, that are used for milk and meat, give it a good clean, okay? It's the same status as glass, it's not going to absorb much, you're cleaning it well with the soap, and that's it, leave me alone, finished. וכן מותר להשתמש בסיר שבישלו בו בשר טרף, אחר שינקו אותו היטב. And there are these same people will say that you can just clean your pot well if you cook trif in it. You clean it well, okay, nothing's absorbed, and that's it. לא זו בלבד, not more than this, אלא שיש טוענים שאף הראשונים שהחמירו בכלי זכוכית, they would hold that even the ראשונים that were strict with glass, אילו היו יודעים בוודאות שאינם בולים ופורטים טעמים, if they would know today that the glass doesn't absorb, היו מסכימים לדעת המתירים, they would for sure agree with the people who permit it. מפני שכל יסוד האיסור בכלים הוא רק מפני הטעם הבלוע בהם. Because the whole essence of why we're making it אסור is because of the taste that is absorbed. ואם בפועל הטעם אינו נבלע בהם, and if there's no taste absorbed, די לנק אותם, ואין צורך להשאיר בעגלה. I just clean it, why do I have to dip it in boiling water for? That's one side. מנגד, conversely, כמעט כל הרבנים סוברים למעשה, almost all the rabbis hold, שחובה להכשיר כלי שבישלו בו טרף, that you're obligated to kosher a utensil that you cook trif with, וכן חובה להכשיר סיר חלבי שבישלו בו בשר או להפך, and that you are obligated to kosher a milk pot where you cooked meat in it, or the opposite. Why? שהואיל ונהגו בישראל מדורי דורות להכשיר כלי מתכות בעגלה או בליבון, because since the custom for so many generations has been to kosher metal with hagala, dipping in hot water, or libun, or with blow torching, חובה להמשיך במנהג המקובל. It's an obligation to continue this מנהג. בנוסף לכך, more, למדנו שחכמים תקנו תקנות רבות כדי לבצר את ההפרדה שבין בשר לחלב, that the rabbis also enacted further decrees over the years to make a separation, to increase that separation between בשר and חלב, וכדי למנוע את האדם ממכשול, to prevent man from stumbling. לכן אסרו בשר וחלב יחד גם כשאינם מבושלים. And that's why they went further to say that we don't mix meat and milk together even when they're not being cooked. ואף אסור לאכול חלב אחר בשר. You can't even eat milk after meat. וכן אסור לאכול בשר על שולחן שיש עליו חלב או להפך. You can't eat milk when people are eating meat at the same table. And vice versa. ואף אסור לאפות פת חלבית או בשרית. You're not allowed to cook dairy bread, bake dairy bread. You're not allowed to bake meat bread. שמה יתו לאוכלה עם המין השני, lest you come and eat it with the other type of food. All this was Chachamim instituted. ניתן לומר שמתחייב מתקנות אלו שלא להשתמש באותם הכלים לבשר וחלב. So, because of these תקנות, it has been established that we don't use the same kelim for meat and milk, ולא בכלי טרף למאכלים כשרים, and not with טרף pots for kosher foods, ולהקפיד על כל דיני הכשרה שחלו על כלי מתכת שפלטו טעמים, גם בכלי מתכת שאינם פולטים טעמים. And just like we established the rules with a metal pot that does emit the taste, so too we will establish the same rules for a metal pot that doesn't. שאם לא יקפידו על כך, and if we're not strict with this, יש חשש שיבשלו בכלי טרף שאינם נקיים מאכלים כשרים. You might come to cook kosher foods in a treif pot that is not clean. ויבואו לבשל בכלי בשר שאינם נקיים חלב, או להפך, ויעברו איסור בשר וחלב. Or you're going to cook milk in a meat pot and the meat pot isn't clean. And then you're mamash being over an איסור in the Torah of cooking basar b'chalav. So לסיכום, to summarize, דעת רובם המכריע של הרבנים, most of the rabbis of the world, שגם לאחר שהתפרש שכלי מתכת אינם בולים ופולטים טעמים, even though we do know that a metal pot does not give off the taste like it used to thousands of years ago, חובת הקשרתם נשארה במקומה, the obligation to dip our pots in case they became non-kosher still remains in place. הן מצד חשיבות שמירת המסורת, whether it's regard to the importance of keeping the מסורת, הן מצד היסוד שלמדנו מכל תקנות חכמים, or with regards to the foundation of all the תקנות את החכמים established, שצריך לבצר את ההפרדה בין בשר וחלב, בין טרף לקשר כדי למנוע ממשול, in order to prevent us from stumbling into חס ושלום, transgressing an עבירה from the Torah. We'll stop here and we'll continue tomorrow.